The following components are included in the scope of delivery of your thermal conductivity meter Lambda. First of all, you will have the electronic box, as well as the sensor, with the screw-on sample cup. There is a mains cable for the power supply of your system. For automatic temperature control of your samples, you have a dry block thermostat, as well as another mains cable for it. To connect the thermostat to your Lambda device, there is a red and black thermostat cable. To connect your Lambda system to your personal computer, you may use the PC cable. If no serial port is available, you can add the serial to USB adapter. First, connect the sensor cable to the electronic box. Use the additional screws to tighten the connection. After this, connect the sub-D ending of the thermostat cable to the thermostat socket. Again, use the screws on both sides to fix the connection. The other ending of this cable should be plugged into the thermostat with the tiny metal pin facing downwards. Use the cap screw to tighten this connection as well. Before adding the power supply, plug in the PC cable and tighten the screws of the connector. Now it's time to add the mains cable for power supply. Simply plug it in. Now your Lambda meter is ready to be switched on. Last, plug in the mains cable of your thermostat. You can now switch on the thermostat as well. If your computer or laptop doesn't have a serial port, you can use the serial to USB connector for adaptation. Make sure that you plug it into the USB port of your computer first and that its driver was installed correctly before connecting the Lambda. You may want to check this by means of the device manager of your PC. Next, you connect the PC cable to your USB adapter. Now, your Lambda meter is connected to your computer and you are ready to prepare for measurement. First, pull the sensor out of the adapter sleeve. Next, you can unscrew the sample cup from the sensor head. Be careful with the last turns of the thread and make sure you hold onto the cup once it's loose. Set the sensor aside carefully and make sure that the sample cup is just as dry and clean as the sensor. Now, fill the cup with 35 ml of your sample. Decant your fluid slowly in order to avoid air entrainment in your sample. The cup should be filled up to the mark right below its inner thread. Grab your Lambda sensor and immerse it gently into the sample. Screw on the cup with slow and steady turns. Once the cup is screwed on tightly, mount the adapter sleeve, which adapts to the inner diameter of the thermostat socket. You may now immerse the sensor into the thermostat. After approximately 1 minute, the first measurement values will be displayed on the LCD of your Lambda meter. You are now ready to use the Flukon software for automatic measurements and sample temperature control with the thermostat. Make sure that you copied your Lambda program to a directory with full administrative access. Click on the program icon to start the software. This is what the program window looks like. Start a measurement by clicking on File or on the empty sheet symbol. Now, the fluid data form will be displayed and will ask you for further information on your sample. First, fill in a fluid name. If you want to conduct heat capacity in addition to thermal conductivity measurement, please fill in the density parameters of your specific fluid. You may also use the calculator function if you have certain nominal densities available, for example from the datasheet of your substance. If you're just looking into thermal conductivity measurement, simply use the default parameters here and proceed with the measurement by clicking on OK. You will now have a screen on which you can select your mode of measurement. Select temperature interval for your automatic temperature dependent measurement. Click on OK and type in your temperature settings such as the start temperature of your run, which should be above your actual temperature, the end temperature of your run, which should be below the flash point of your substance, the temperature increments, as well as the number of isothermal values that you want the system to determine at each increment. Eventually, click on OK to start the measurement. The remote control of the thermostat will now be activated and you will find the first row of your protocol displayed in red until the sample reaches the start temperature of your choice. Notice that the bottom of the program window has a status line, which not only includes information about your system, COM port, and measuring mode, but also the temperature settings. Please note that thermal conductivity measurement requires thermostability, so it also requires a bit of your patience. Depending on your sample and temperature settings, Lambda measurements may take 4 to 16 hours. When your measurement was successful, a message will be displayed. Click on OK and you will be given the option to save your protocol to a directory of your choice. After clicking on Save, you can add a comment, which may include further information on your sample or measurement. Congratulations! Your measurement has been saved and you can now close the program or start another measurement.